गुड इवनिंग प्रियंका मैम, एम आई ऑडियबल?
यस सर, यस सर, यू आर ऑडिबल।
ओके ओके। बट योर वॉइस इज नॉट कमिंग टू मी।
व्हाट सर?
यस
यस, आर यू हियरिंग मी?
So, Priyanka ma'am, are you there?
She is not in this class. She has other class.
Can I see the student? Who is the student? Am I audible now?
Yes sir, yes sir, you are audible.
Okay, okay. So can I talk to a student who is going to read now?
Sir Arpit Sharma.
Yes, Arpit Sharma. Okay. So Arpit Sharma, I am Rajesh Kumar, chemistry faculty. Okay. So now you are in 10th class. Yes.
Yes, sir.
And what is your percentage in 9th class? Can you tell me? I want a simple interaction between me and you so that we could connect to each other at least, because the connect like physical class is not possible, but there should be at least some connect between me and you so that we could proceed further, we could discuss a subject. Okay, so please tell me about yourself.
My name is Arpit Sharma.
Okay.
I belong to Jaipur.
Yes.
And I am a 10th class student and school is Mount Carmel Convent School.
Okay. So you are comfort in Hindi or in English or in a bilingual? That means in both Hindi and English?
Sir, both.
Okay, okay. And Devansi? Devansi, can you tell me a brief introduction of you? Okay, so how many chapters you have covered until now in your class, in your general class, in your school class basically? Because there are 5 chapters in chemistry. And now I hope you are also able to see my screen.
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Are you able to see this board or not?
Yes, sir.
Your voice is not very clear to me. You are able to see this board?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is your chemistry class. I just want to discuss that which chapter of class 10th you have studied in your school up to now.
The chemical reactions and equations.
Okay. And
acids, bases and salts. But okay, it is not complete.
Any chapter is not completed?
Yes, acid, bases and salts I have.
Okay, acids, bases and salts.
It is not complete.
Okay, but it is not complete.
Yes, introduction part only I have done.
Okay, okay. So today what you would like to study, acid, base and salts or?
Chemical reactions and equations.
Okay, you want to like to study chemical reaction and equations, yes?
Yes.
Okay. So today I will discuss this chapter with you and I would like to go in the detail in such a way that I will ask some questions from you and you will ask some questions from me so that a healthy interactions could be developed between me and you. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So first of all, to discuss chemical reaction and equations, this is very interesting chapter and very basic chapter in chemistry. Okay? Because in whole 9th class you do not read any chemical reactions and equations. So that's why this is the first chapter of class 10th, chemical reaction and equation. This is very basic chapter of chemical reactions and equations, very basic chapter of chemistry. It is helpful in understanding acid, base and salts, metal, non-metals, okay?
Yes.
And even carbon and its compound. These are your next chapters. So this chapter is basically a base to understand these other chapters. Okay? तो ठीक है, हम लोग शुरू करते हैं अबाउट केमिकल रिएक्शन एंड इक्वेशंस. तो कैन यू टेल मी अ जनरल डेफिनेशन दैट हाउ यू डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन केमिकल रिएक्शन एंड इक्वेशन? इज देयर एनी डिफरेंस बिटवीन रिएक्शन एंड इक्वेशन?
यस सर.
यस, प्लीज टेल मी.
सर, रिएक्शन इज द प्रोसेस इन विच वन और सब्सटेंस रिएक्ट टू फॉर्म प्रोडक्ट.
ओके.
Equation is a symbolic representation of the formula.
Exactly.
Symbolic representation of the reaction.
Okay, okay. Yes, you are almost right. That chemical reaction is the process of chemical conversion. This is the process of chemical conversion when matter converts from one form to another form. Then the process is known as chemical reaction. Okay?
Yes.
And the symbolic, or sometimes we also represent in word form. Okay?
Yes.
So symbolic or word representation of chemical change is known as are you able to see whatever I am writing on the board?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Whatever chemical change, the symbolic or word representation of chemical change is known as chemical equation.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the basic difference between this. Some are symbolic equations, some are word equation. For example, if you write hydrogen plus oxygen react together to form water,
H2O.
Okay, so this is the word equation, and when we use the specific standard symbols like H2 plus O2 gives you H2O. So this is the chemical symbolic equation. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So generally chemists use this method. This is suitable for chemist and this is suitable for general person.
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes.
So we will utilize this method, and if this reaction is not balanced, okay, if it is not balanced or it is written in simply the skeletal form, okay, so
yes,
this equation is also known as skeletal equation.
Yes.
So, do you know what is skeletal equation?
Yes. No.
Yes or no?
No.
No. Okay. Skeletal equation means the simple representation of any chemical change. Skeleton equation. Okay. Now I will discuss this skeleton equation on next page. Just wait. Skeleton, or sometimes it is also known as skeletal. Skeletal equation means the basic form of any chemical equation. That means unbalanced chemical equation, or sometimes known as unbalanced chemical equation.
Yes.
Okay, is known as skeletal equation. For example, magnesium plus oxygen gives you magnesium oxide. So here oxygen atoms are not balanced, that's why this is skeleton. Okay, yes, and if you balance this equation, Mg plus O2 gives you MgO, magnesium oxide. Then by balancing 2 here, now it is balanced?
Yes, sir.
So this is the balanced chemical equation. So skeletal equation are simply the basic form of equation which is generally written before balancing. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So any equation, for example, H2 plus O2 gives you H2O. Now this is a skeleton. After balancing, it is balanced chemical equation. Okay?
Yes.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is given in your NCERT book. NCERT in second page, you will found a skeleton equation. Okay? Second, third page पर आपको मिलेगा. This is skeleton equation. Now, the most important thing in chemistry is that how to write chemical equation. Okay? Because if a chemist does not know how to write chemical equation, how to balance chemical equation, how to balance chemical equation, and how to identify a chemical reaction, okay, or chemical change, chemical equation or chemical change, these all things are very important for any chemist.
Okay.
So I hope in ninth class you have read about the chemical change.
Yes, sir.
So you can easily identify that which change are chemical change and which change are physical changes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So can you tell me growth of plant?
Chemical change.
Only chemical or both?
Chemical change.
Yes.
So chemical change.
Only chemical change. Physical change नहीं होता है. When plant growth, इसकी physical strength भी increase होती है, mass भी increase होता है. But all things are result of chemical change, no doubt. Okay, chemical change is in dominant mode, but physical change is also there. Yes or no?
Yeah, okay, sir.
Okay, chemical. And let us suppose rusting of iron.
Chemical change.
Only chemical again?
Physical. How change. Both.
Okay, chemical plus physical. Okay, but dominant is chemical change.
Chemical.
Okay, so burning of coal.
Both.
Burning of coal.
Chemical and physical.
Okay, but this is only chemical change. For example, carbon. Combustion in presence of oxygen gives you carbon dioxide. What is physical change here? Carbon atoms are going to chemically combine with oxygen atom to form carbon dioxide. A new product is formed. Okay. In these all things, chemical change is in dominant mode. Basically, this is chemical change. This is chemical change. Burning of coal is especially this is the chemical change. How we identify that a particular change is physical or chemical? Can you suggest me some method?
Chemical change will not reversible.
Okay.
physical change is reversible.
Not reversible chemical change.
Physical.
Physical change are not reversible.
Sir, physical change are reversible.
Okay, and chemical change?
Not reversible.
Not reversible. But let one example, please. This is H2 plus O2 gives you H2O. Okay?
Yes, sir.
This is a one process. And in another process, H2O electrolyze. This is electrolysis. And it gives you hydrogen plus oxygen gas.
Yes, sir.
So what do you will say? It is reversible or irreversible?
Reversible.
So now you have to update your definition of chemical change. That chemical change can be reversed in different physical conditions.
Okay.
Okay. Chemical change may reverse in a different chemical, different physical conditions. That means if surrounding conditions are going to change, then a particular chemical compound may convert into reverse, may convert into its basic constituent molecules. Okay. So now any other parameter on the basis of which you decide that a particular change is chemical or not? Yes, any other, please, if you have. Okay. Then just try to understand. I am discussing criteria for chemical change. Okay. One criteria which you have told me, which you that it is reversible, it is irreversible. But I have given you an example that chemical change may be reversible in a particular condition. Another criteria, the must criteria, a new substance
will form.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Will form. This is the necessary criteria. If new substance is not being formed, then we cannot say that this is chemical change.
Yes, sir.
In any chemical change, this is compulsory that new substance should be formed.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the compulsory criteria. Without this, we cannot say for any change that it is chemical change or physical change.
Yes, sir.
This is compulsory condition. New substance should be formed. For example, in C+O2, you are seeing carbon dioxide is being formed. A new substance is formed from these two basic constituent substance. In the similar way, H2O gives you hydrogen plus oxygen. New substance, hydrogen and oxygen are being formed. Yes, so these all are chemical changes. Okay, so when this new substance is formed, then there are some sub criteria to defend this new substance. For example, if new substance formed is gas, then we can say that a gas or sometime a liquid form or sometime a solid also form. So generally, phase of substance change. Okay. It may be change or may not. But generally, phase of substance change. Okay. For example, carbon is in solid state. I am writing here. Carbon in solid state react with oxygen in gaseous state to form carbon dioxide gas. That means initially you have some substance in solid form. After some time, you will check that all substance has been converted into this gaseous phase. Okay?
Okay.
So this is the sub criteria to identify a chemical change. And another thing, color of system change. Okay, generally if new substance is formed, so it is not necessary that the color of previous substance and a new substance are same. So generally color of system also change.
Okay.
Another thing, pressure and temperature.
Temperature change.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Also change. Because if some more amount of gas will form, then pressure will increase obviously in the vessel. And if a reaction is exothermic in nature, if exothermic reaction is there, then energy will release and temperature will increase. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And if endothermic reaction is there,
heat will be absorbed.
Then heat will absorb, yes, and it may be cooled down or temperature will decrease.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these are the some sub criteria to identify a chemical change, in which this is the compulsory criteria. Other all are supporting criteria.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So after understanding about the criteria of chemical change and the difference between chemical reaction and chemical equation, now I will discuss some category, some types of chemical reaction. Okay.
Okay.
So I think you already know one or two or three types.
Yes.
I will discuss, try to discuss those types of reaction which you don't know. Okay. So types of chemical reaction. Now, types of chemical reaction. How many types do you know?
Four, five.
Okay. Please tell me the name.
Combination reaction.
Okay, combination. Can you give me any example for this?
I can define.
Okay, define, please.
Sir, in which two tend form one product, single product.
Okay. It is necessary that there should be two reactants.
Two or more.
Two or more, yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, these reaction will be exothermic or endothermic in nature?
Endothermic.
Endothermic. Then, just try to understand that combination reactions, whenever two or more than two reactants chemically combine to each other. Yes, chemically combine, not physically combine to each other. What is the meaning of chemically combine?
To react.
The reaction is known as combination reaction, or sometimes also known as synthesis reaction. Okay. Synthesis or combination, both are same thing. Yes. What is the meaning of chemically combined?
Reaction of reactant.
Okay. Chemically combined, the meaning of chemically combined is this, that they transfer or share electrons with each other. Okay.
Okay.
And transfer and sharing of electron is known as formation of chemical bond. Formation of chemical bond. So chemically combining means whenever they are forming chemical bond, it will be known as chemical combination, and such reactions will be known as combination reactions if two or more than two reactants chemically combine to each other. This is known as formation of chemical bond. For example, try to understand that, let us suppose carbon. This is carbon, three atom, oxygen, three molecule. If they are forming CO2, then how C and O are combined to each other? C has four electrons in outer shell. Oxygen needs two electrons because it has six electrons in outer shell. You already have teach how many electrons are available in outer shell of oxygen and carbon in ninth class. Yes?
Yes.
So each of these required eight electrons in its octet. These are eight. And these are eight for carbon.
Okay.
Okay. So this is the process of chemical combination. That atoms or reactants share or transfer their electrons to each other and they form chemical bond. Okay. And when chemical bonds are formed, new chemical bonds, जब भी new chemical bonds बनेंगे आपके, whenever new chemical bonds are formed, for example, C and O2 are going to convert into CO2. That means CO2 is more stable. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Because if it is not stable, then it will not change. It will not chemically convert into CO2. CO2 yes. is going to...
Their octet is complete.
Yes?
Their octet is complete.
Yes. So that's why CO2 is more stable than C and O2 at this particular temperature and pressure. That's why CO2 is being formed. That means it is more stable. So whenever new chemical bonds are formed, so stability generally increases. Stability increases. And if stability increases, that means energy will released.
Released.
And energy is released, then your reaction will be known as एक्सोथर्मिक। तो आपने क्या बताया था ये रिएक्शन किस तरह की होगी?
एंडोथर्मिक।
तो नाउ यू कैन करेक्ट योर आंसर।
यस सर।
ओके?
यस सर।
तो दिस इज द टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शन। ऑल कॉम्बिनेशन रिएक्शंस आर एक्सोथर्मिक इन नेचर। ओके? ऑल केमिकल रिएक्शंस आर एक्सोथर्मिक इन नेचर। A plus B gives you C. This okay. type of reactions are exothermic in nature. Okay.
Yes,
second,
sir.
Second category is
sir,
the reverse of combination reaction.
What?
Known as decomposition.
Yes, sir.
So this is simply reverse of
combination reaction.
Combination. तो इसका टाइप क्या होगा एंडोथर्मिक और एक्सोथर्मिक
सर इट एंडोथर्मिक
एग्जैक्टली बिकॉज नाउ इन दिस रिवर्स रिएक्शन व्हाट यू हैव टू डन एक्चुअली इन कॉम्बिनेशन रिएक्शन दीज बॉन्ड्स वर फॉर्म इन डिकम्पोजिशन यू हैव टू ब्रेक दीज बॉन्ड्स
यस सर
फॉर एग्जांपल
हीट इज अप्लाइड
यस H2O In H2O, there are bonds like this, hydrogen, oxygen, hydrogen. These are bonds?
Yes.
So, by applying electrolysis, by applying electricity, you can decompose H2O molecule into hydrogen plus oxygen.
Yes.
Okay? So, you yes. have to break the bonds. So, to break the bonds, what is required? Energy is required. Okay.
Yes.
So that's why it will be endothermic in nature.
Yes, sir.
These are two type of chemical reactions, combination reactions and decomposition reactions. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, can you define how many types of decomposition reactions are there?
I don't know.
Now I will discuss second category. You have read about the decomposition reaction. Now the subcategory, subtypes of decomposition reactions. So what is the deciding factor in decomposition reaction? Energy supply. If you will not supply energy, then your chemical reaction is not going to take place. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this is the deciding factor. This energy may be of various types. For example, some molecule can decompose by supplying some thermal heat. Okay, so known as thermal decomposition.
Okay, sir.
If your molecule is going to break by supplying some amount of direct heat, then it will be known as thermal decomposition. For example, you have calcium carbonate in solid form. You supply some amount of heat. This delta is used for heat.
Yes, sir.
Then convert into solid plus carbon dioxide gas. So this is a chemical change which occurs in presence of some external heat. So that's why it is known as thermal decomposition.
Yes, sir.
Okay?
Okay, sir.
Some molecule break in presence of sunlight only. That means their bond energy is very less. So some molecules decompose in presence of sunlight, and that is known as photolytic decomposition.
Okay, sir.
Okay, that means chemical bond breaks, chemical bond breaks in presence of simply sunlight.
Okay.
Simply sunlight. This sunlight is also represented by H nu.
Okay.
So for example, AgCl molecule. You have AgCl. In presence of H nu, you will get Ag plus chlorine. Is it clear?
Okay, sir.
And see, some molecules. Yes.
Electricity.
Yes, please ask.
Electricity. The third reaction, electricity.
Yes, yes. Electrolytic decomposition.
Okay, sir.
And third one is electrolytic decomposition. Okay. For example, water on electrolysis gives you hydrogen plus oxygen. So these are various types of decomposition reaction.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
These all reactions are always endothermic in nature.
Yes, sir.
Some amount of energy always will be absorbed during the process of this chemical change, such type of chemical change. So, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, so another type of reaction, can you tell me?
Displacement reaction.
Displacement. So what is the definition, how you identify?
The more reactive element will displace the less reactive element.
Okay, this is on the basis of reactivity. Yes?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है, यू नो तो डिस्प्लेसमेंट जनरली कंसीडर कैटेगराइज इनटू टू कैटेगरी, सिंगल एंड डबल. यस, सो कैन यू टेल मी दैट लेट अस सपोज आई हैव Fe प्लस Al2O3, देन व्हाट विल बी द प्रोडक्ट?
Al2FeO3.
Yes. Al2FeO3. Oh, this is iron. This is aluminium here.
Okay.
Can you tell me what will be the product? What should be product here?
Al2FeO3.
Al2FeO3.
Yes,
that means combination reaction as per
you. Al2 plus Al3.
Okay. You are saying aluminium plus Fe2O3. Basically, to understand displacement reaction, you should know about the reactivity of metals. तो क्या आपको लर्न है रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज ऑफ मेटल्स? लर्न है या नहीं?
नहीं सर.
नो?
नो सर.
ओके, कोई बात नहीं. लर्न नहीं है तो मैं आपको लर्न करा दूंगा, क्योंकि अगर आपको इसकी रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज लर्न होती तो इसका आंसर था दैट दिस रिएक्शन कैन नॉट टेक प्लेस. दिस रिएक्शन
कैन नॉट
टेक प्लेस बिकॉज aluminium, that means Al, is more reactive than Fe.
Then reactivity is, I think, in non-metals, metals and non-metals.
Okay, so this reaction cannot take place because iron is more reactive than aluminium. So this is not possible.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So other reaction, like let us suppose you have aluminium plus H2SO4 solution, then there will be reaction Al2SO4 whole thrice plus hydrogen gas. This reaction can take place because aluminium is more reactive than hydrogen, so it will displace hydrogen from this acid. Okay, and this is known as single displacement. So for this you have to learn reactivity series. So now I am going to introduce the reactivity series. So if you will learn this reactivity series, then it will be very easy to identify or to write the product of any chemical reaction. Okay. So reactivity series of metals. Now, this is very important and it will also be utilized in third chapter.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you should learn this. Generally, metals are categorized into three categories: highly reactive metals, moderately reactive metals, and less reactive metals.
Yes.
highly reactive metals are.
Potassium, sodium, calcium.
Yes, 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 yes. Please tell me.
Potassium, sodium, calcium.
Potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium,
aluminium.
Okay. Aluminium, zinc,
iron, lead.
Iron, very good.
Lead.
Lead. Okay.
Yes.
Copper, mercury, silver, gold. Silver. This is gold. Okay. After gold, it is platinum. Ag, then Au, and then platinum. So these are highly reactive. These are
moderately reactive.
Moderately reactive. And these are
least reactive.
Less reactive. Okay. So इनके basis पर इनकी chemical reactions बनाई जाती हैं. For example, now I will told you how to write the chemical reaction related to this reactivity series. For example, if you have copper sulfate solution, okay, and you are going to add some zinc powder, then reaction will take place or not? You can check. That copper is here, that means less reactive. Zinc is more reactive than copper. That's why the reaction will take place and it will displace copper and will form zinc sulfate solution, and copper will convert into solid. Okay. ऐसे ये reactions लिखी जाती हैं. ओके नेक्स्ट रिएक्शन अब आप बताइएगा मुझको. फॉर एग्जांपल नाउ यू हैव कॉपर प्लस जिंक सल्फेट. कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट विल बी द प्रोडक्ट? Am I audible? Am I audible to you? Can you tell me what could be the product? I'm not able to hear you.
Yes, sir.
Your voice is breaking. Are you able to listen me?
Yes, sir.
Your voice is breaking. Okay.
Yes, sir. Your audible. Are you hearing me?
Yes. So copper and zinc sulfate, what will be the product? Copper is less reactive, as you can see here. Zinc is more reactive. So copper cannot displace zinc from zinc sulfate solution. Yes or no? So there will be no reaction.
Hello.
Yes.
Actually, sir, I was.
Yes, please tell me what is the problem.
My Zoom switched off. Hello.
Yes.
The connection was lost. That's why I was logged out.
Okay. Now it is okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these are some example of chemical change based upon metal reactivity series. I also introduced a new substance, that is hydrogen, which is not metal. And this hydrogen line between lead and copper.
Yes, sir.
Okay. That means these all metals can displace hydrogen.
Okay, sir.
From any acid. For example, if you have acid H2SO4 and plus, let us suppose, potassium. Then what will be the result? Potassium sulfate plus hydrogen gas. Yeah. That means potassium will displace hydrogen from this acid. But if you have any other acid like HCl plus copper, then no reaction. Okay, so this is the meaning of reactivity. The copper is less reactive than hydrogen, so it cannot displace hydrogen from acid.
Okay, sir.
Is it clear? So you have to learn this reactivity series. If you can learn, then all the reactions related to single displacement will be easy to write. Okay. So these are the types of chemical reactions. Any other type of chemical reaction which you have learned?
Double displacement reaction.
Double displacement is the subcategory of this same reaction.
Yes.
Except this. The fourth category of reaction you have learned, I think, that is oxidation reaction or redox reaction.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
These are the category of reactions, redox reactions. Okay. So, can you define how you identify that a reaction is redox or not?
It has two category.
Okay, which one?
Sir, of losing oxygen atom and gaining oxygen atom.
Okay, losing. Loss
it
of.
Means reduction of oxygen.
Okay, loss of oxygen and gain of oxygen.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So loss of oxygen is known as reduction, okay, as per your definition, and gain of oxygen is oxidation.
Yes.
These both reactions takes place simultaneously or at different time?
Simultaneously.
Okay. For example, C plus O2 gives you CO2, H2O gives you H2 plus O2. These both are redox reactions or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes.
These both are redox?
I think so.
Sayad? This is going to gain some oxygen. As per your definition, this is going to gain some oxygen. but oxygen itself is going to decrease, amount of oxygen will decrease definitively, so it is going to reduce. In this, what is, there are two processes should be involved here also. Okay, don't worry, this is very limited definition which you are telling me, that loss of oxygen and gain of oxygen, this is right, no doubt this is right definition, but this is very limited. There are some other criteria to decide any redox reactions. Okay, there are many criteria to decide redox reactions, to decide oxidation and reduction process. So now the time is almost up. In this class we cannot continue with redox reactions, but in next class we may discuss the other criteria of redox reactions. For example, I will summarize here that oxidation is gain of oxygen. You know very well to this point that oxidation is the gain of oxygen, and I will say that oxygen is also the loss of hydrogen. If any molecule is going to lose hydrogen, then this is also oxidation. Okay,
with loss of oxygen, hydrogen is gain.
Yes,
but with the loss of oxygen, hydrogen is gained.
Yes, another definition of oxidation is loss of electron. Loss of electron is also oxidation.
Okay,
loss of electron is also oxidation. So these are three criteria of oxidation. इसके अलग अलग एग्जाम्पल हम समझ सकते हैं. दिस इज द फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल, C+O2 CO2, दैट मीन्स कार्बन इज बींग ऑक्सीडाइज. हियर कार्बन इज बींग ऑक्सीडाइज. Okay,
can you tell me which is reducing agent and
yes,
can you tell me which is reduce agent?
Yes, if carbon is being oxidized and oxygen is being reduced. Okay. So oxygen is being reduced in presence of carbon, reduction okay. In presence of कार्बन, तो जिसकी प्रेजेंस में रिडक्शन होगा दैट सब्सटेंस विल बी नोन एज रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट. तो दिस इज रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट हियर, कार्बन इज रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट एंड देयर ऑक्सीजन इज ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट.
ओके सर,
रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट इज कार्बन एंड ऑक्सीजन इज ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट.
ओके सर.
ओके
ओके सर.
So in next class we will discuss in detail about the redox reactions, reducing agent, oxidizing agent and all other things related to redox reactions, and types of redox reaction I will also discuss. Okay. So now you can ask me any query which you have about whatever we have discussed today. No. Okay,
thank you sir.
So do you have any query or any doubt? Yes or no?
No sir.
No. So it's okay, Arpit.
Okay sir.
No. So okay, and one more thing. Am I audible?
Yes sir.
Can I see your face? Can you on your video? I am also starting my video. okay, so that I could recognize. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
So I hope you enjoyed the session.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So thank you and have a nice day.
Thank you, sir.